No matter the distance drawn between it, my body and my mind, I can still recall. I recall the tragic notes of bloodshed, a war which should have never happened, the Console War. Two worlds exist in game industry, that of humans and that of Celestia, where the CPU resided. The CPU gained her powers through the faith of humanity, who in turn gained the CPU's protection. It was well balanced. The world below and the goddess who ruled it, one for one. That was how things were supposed to be. However, the former goddess and I broke this careful balance and created four separate goddesses, four CPUs. The Celestia, ruled in tranquility, no longer existed. It turned into something I would never have anticipated. The four CPUs grew to despise one another and began to fight for the honor of ruling over the world. The land where the four CPUs resided turned into the stage for a tragic war. All due to my ignorance. No matter how I torment myself, being far, far away from the CPUs, all I can do is wait here. Someday, the destiny of these CPUs may save them from her scheme.
Neptune, you're getting out of hand. You two should let this grudge go as well. It's getting rather warm in here.
I'm tired of hearing that nonsense. We've been fighting for thousands of generations. Why quit now?
It's not just about Celestia. That's what I heard from the former goddess. I won't let any of you selfish, icy bitches take the title of true goddess.
Hush now. Where did you learn such raucous manners? You think your demeanor is acceptable as a goddess?
Shut your hole! I can't stand the way you talk all high and mighty. Get out of here, thunder tits!
What? Breasts are symbolic for both maturity and fertility. The size of my bust equates my aptitude as a goddess. With such logic, it can be said you and Neptune are the least fitting.
The hell's that? Listen to that crap talking out your ass. I'll kill you! Die!
We can't afford to waste time berating each other. We're nowhere near settling this.
We'll settle it just fine, even if you hadn't brought it up. But the result won't be what you hoped for.
You really are completely different when you've activated HDD. I kind of like it. It makes me want to try even harder.
True. It has been eons, and we've only come to a stalemate. Surely you're not implying you've been slacking off.
Nevertheless, we've come here for a fight, so let's keep fighting!
Come now. Isn't this getting a bit sterile? Let's think carefully for a moment about one another. This is all for the people in the human world below. Settling this matter is also for their sake.
Your point? You think we can settle it in one day? Just like that?
What I mean is, why don't we work together for once?
Huh, like a happy family? Please, that idea won't solve anything. Competition drives game industry forward.
But the way things are now are failing to work as well. Why not erase just one of us?
Sure. That could be the catalyst of change we've been searching for. To make it easier later on, we should rid ourselves of the one we find difficult to fight, not someone we personally despise.
Well, I hate you. I'm the one who'll finish you off, so you're staying for now.
Composure gets on my nerves. I'd love to teach you discipline with my own hands.
I don't have anyone in particular, but if I had to pick somebody, I suppose I'd aim to take you down.
Sure, I guess. We don't really have anything in common. Then who's left?
You can't just decide this without gathering my opinion as well, can you?
Neptune, be honored. You've chosen to signal the beginning of the end of the console war.
Don't be foolish. Well, it doesn't matter. Even against the three of you, Neptune does what you all don't. Do as you wish to me. I'll counter your attacks 100-fold. There's little point to this if she wakes up and fights us again. Why don't we simply exile her to the world below?
We ain't gonna kill her.
As blunt as ever. If you could, can you save this discussion for after you win against me? I'm not sure if we can kill her or not. This is a first for us. The former goddess taught us nothing of this situation. Did you just ignore me again? Yeah, you did. You'll regret this.
And so will you. You said we three won't stand a chance against you? Well, we're going all out. But I won't listen.
Are you ready?
Too late for regrets.
Back up or not? Your life ends here. Target.
Take this axe, which smashed the heavens!
Oh!
It's dark. Like, pitch black. Where am I? Oh, was there a power outage? Where's the circuit breaker? But why am I glowing like I've been splashed with fluorescent paint and stuck under a black light? Whatever. Hello? Is anyone here? Can I walk around? Don't blame me if I start to collect rings floating by the ground. But ew, who knows what I could step in? It could be something like ABC gum. Should I just wait for more text boxes to pop up? Jeez, I am bored. Whose message am I waiting for anyway?
I apologize for the delay. Have you been here long?
Whoa, a voice. I hear a voice. Delay for what? My soul to go to heaven? No, I don't want to die yet.
Please, stop being so confused. I did not intend to scare you with my words. I am Istvar, a tome. You have fallen to the world below Celestia. I am reaching out to you to ask a favor.
Tomb? I knew it. I'm so dead. What do I want on my tombstone, right? What world below? Below what? Below hell?
Please, Neptune, take a deep breath. You have not died. You have merely fallen unconscious.
Then, Ms. Heavenly Voice, how do you know my name?
I know you are in doubt, but I am Istvar, the tome that has assisted the goddesses of Celestia for generations. I stand for the world's everything. And the world is my everything. There is nothing I do not know. Plus, I created you. Of course I know your name.
So you, like, gave birth to me or whatever. You're my mom. You've got kids? I see.
Do not make it sound like that. I created, not birth. Why do you have such a disappointed tone? I understand this is a new sensation for you. I have been apart from you all for ages, locked away from this world.
Oh, okay, gotcha. So my dad locked you up and ran away with me soon after I was born?
You are taking this in an entirely inappropriate direction. I clearly said it is not like that. I created you and the other three CPUs with the former goddess. That was, however, a dire error. I only wish to end the tragedy caused by my own mistake. Please, help me.
Shut up! Oh, crackers. Did I break something? Where am I? My room? Oh, you're up! Good morning, sleepyhead! Well, good afternoon, technically. This isn't my room, huh? Is it yours? Why am I tucked into your bed so snugly? Well, let's see. It all happened last night. I was looking up into the sky and saw a shooting star. That was you. I was a shooting star? Are you yanking my hoodie strings? I fell from the sky? I'm pretty sure. I followed you to the ground with my eyes and you definitely slammed into the earth like a spear. You from the ground, you pierced so elegantly and carried you to my bed.
since you were passed out.
All by yourself? That's cool. Thanks. You're a lot stronger than you look.
I attend a nursing school. Transporting limp bodies is part of our training, so I'm used to it. My name is Kampa.
Oh, I'm Neptune. Kampa, huh? Then should I call you whatever. Kampa's fine.
It's nice to meet you, Neptumor?
Oh, is it confusing you? Okay, then you can call me Neptuna, Nep-Nep, Neppermint, or something else.
Okay, then I pick Nep-Nep. It's nice to meet you, Nep-Nep. You're all beat up everywhere. Allow me to take a look real quick.
Oh, yeah, I am kind of scraped up, huh? Thanks, nurse in training. I am trusting you with this important task.
Sure, but I've just started. And I'm not too savvy. I get bandages all tangled up. Your injuries aren't bad, but the scratches need disinfecting. After that, I'll wrap you up. It might sting a little, but hang in there. How much bandage should I use? A little? A lot?
Use it all up. Wrap me up good so it doesn't come loose. Besides, it's a waste if they don't last.
Okay, then I'll just use what I have. Please let me know if it's too tight. This way. That way. Loop it over.
Huh? No, hold on. Slow down. Be careful.
I don't want it to come loose or you'll trip over it.
Can't breathe, can't make more comments.
Nep-Nep? Did I do it too tight after all? Please get a hold of yourself. I'll unwrap you right.
It's tighter now. You're just tangling me up. Stop! Give me scissors. Give me now. Put them in my hands, and I'll do it myself. By the way, I was thinking while you were wrapping me in bandages, where am I?
They're bandages! We're in the central city of Planetune.
Okay. I remember someone mentioning the world below.
Yes, that's absolutely correct. This is one of the major landmasses beneath Celestia.
One of the landmasses? So there are several?
Why, yes. There are four major landmasses floating around. Sometimes they come close to one another and drift away. Remember?
Nope, not at all. Planetune, land masses, rings no bells for me.
Maybe you're suffering from amnesia. I've never seen a case in person. How original! Maybe you bumped your head.
Isn't there medication or something for that?
No, not for amnesia. It's usually a temporary thing. I'm sure you'll begin to recall things eventually. My grandpa always said, fancy may kill or cure. Get some sleep, take it easy, and you'll be better in no time.
Get some sleep? I feel like someone asked me to do something while I was unconscious. Yeah, someone was crying out for help in my dream.
In your dream? Then it's not real.
Oh, you never know. It was so weird. I bet you someone far away was like, pachoo, and sent me a telepathic message, you know?
It's possible. Actually, many places, Planetude included, are being threatened by more and more monsters lately. The military powers failed to keep them from appearing. We can only defend ourselves and keep them at bay now.
Then, there must be a boss generating all these monsters somewhere. My mission is to go defeat that boss and save the world!
You may be right about a boss, but nobody has seen or heard anything like that. How will you find it? This is irrational, dangerous, and absolutely impossible!
Nobody is gonna beat the boss if we just sit here. Someone's gotta take initiative, you know? Can't ignore this once I've noticed it. Haven't you heard, strike while the iron's hot?
I believe Grandpa did have a saying like that. Yes, that's right. I wanted to be a nurse to save people. So, why would I save the injured, but not those being threatened by monsters? How impolite of me! I'm not the strongest, but I'll help! Two is better than one!
You will? Don't you have school? You're not in the middle of summer vacation or anything, right?
Right, but the city's population has been declining due to monsters eating them. Students are leaving school out of fear, so it's closed down for now. Classes are suspended until further notice.
Means you can camp out, right? Goody. Let's go find the dungeon where the boss is waiting. Is this the dungeon you found searching Dungle Maps? Yeah, it feels like a dungeon with lots of tough monsters.
No, no strong monsters here. I search for dungeons with weak monsters. We're not ready for the strong ones yet.
What? Only weaklings? Then I'll wait where I won't encounter any, and you can come get me when you find the boss.
That's not fair. We're a party, so we're basically soulmates. Party now goes against the rules of this world. You'll get punished by the goddess.
Goddess? So not only are there monsters, but there's a goddess here too?
You didn't know? Silly amnesia. But forgetting even the goddesses? Oh, you poor thing. Planetune, there are three other landmasses. Lestation, Leanbox, and Louis. Each planet is protected by a goddess, and people go to the Basilicum to worship them and help govern each land. We have no idea where the monsters are coming from. Their power just grows and grows. Everyone thinks it's due to the goddess's weakening powers. Heated discussions take place every night on the Basilicom's blog.
Basilicom? So, what kind of place is that? Is one nearby? Do they bake cookies?
Nap, nap. Enough banter. We should get going before the weak monsters get tired of waiting for us.
Thank you. one's nice.
Ending.
Thank you.
try me from any angle.
Neptune, can you hear me? This is Histoire.
Isti, thanks for that awesome tutorial. What's up? Isti? Nep-Nep, who are you talking to? Nobody's here except for you and me.
You can't hear her?
Isti, can you talk to Compa too?
I apologize. But at this time, you are the only one I can speak with. Please pass my words to your friend when I am through. Also, I do not think I am comfortable with the name Isti.
Sorry, Compa. I'll just tell you what she says later. Anyway, Isti, I found something weird and shiny just now.
You refer to the key fragment, I assume. That is an important item needed to release me from the seal.
Seal? Where are you at, anyway?
I am uncertain. Somebody has locked me away somewhere in this world. Please, please, release the seal and save me. In each land, you will find a key fragment. First, please collect these items.
Key fragments? If I do this fetch quest, I can save you, right? So where are they?
Unfortunately, I have little information on that. I only know there is one on each landmass. You have collected one already. Each piece is guarded by a strong adversary. Find the fragments by defeating these foes.
So, I get that I have to save you, but should I really do all this for someone I don't even know?
It is only natural to feel that way. Others do not trust me either. However, you are my last and only hope. Please do this and save me.
It's tough for me to say no, but finding all these thingies sounds like a real bore chore.
Are you concerned? There is no need. I am sure you can do this.
No, I mean, I'm gonna do all this stuff just to save one person. Can't it be like, to save the whole world?
How honest. As I said, I am the world's everything, and the world is mine. Saving me is tantamount to saving the world.
Huh? Really? Oh, well, okay then. Don't stop there. Pump me up some more.
By defeating the various monsters in order to obtain the pieces, you will save countless lives all across the world.
Killing two birds with one stone. I like it. Anything else to boost my drive?
I wish I could add 1,000,000 credits to your savings, but that is a little beyond my control.
That's so much. I better get my stomp on. Nap, Nap, why are you so excited? I can't hear anything. I don't hear this person's voice. Sorry, Kampa. Let's go have something to eat, and I'll talk to you about it for hours and hours and hours! But Kampa, Isti's voice will never reach a crybaby. Come on, buck up, kiddo.